Starship V3 is coming soon. After months of speculation and only two V2 prototypes remaining, SpaceX has released an impressive new trailer showcasing the V3's sleek nose cone. The images show improved strength, aerodynamics, and the ability to reuse things. What does this new reveal mean for the future of Starship? How will these components help with new missions and capabilities? Let's dive deeper in today's episode of NR Studio to see what the V3 ship can do and why it matters. 2025 looks set to be a pivotal year for SpaceX Starship program. The year kicked off with the launch of the second version, but now many are surprised to see that version 3 is about to be released. This improved design is set to launch in the second half of the year, marking the next major step in Starship's development. This new version of Starship has been talked about for several years. This version aims to address many of the issues that arose during the V1 and V2 flights. After numerous initial V2 flights and months of behind-the-scenes work, V3 is finally ready. Updates from the launch site and tests now indicate that V3 is ready for its first operation. Changes to the ring stand at Massey and new test tank prototypes suggest that the V3 will be launched first on Starship 39 alongside B-18. Recent photos from inside Starship Factory indicate they are producing more V3 nose cones than expected. The photos show nose cones S39 through S44 being manufactured, suggesting that at least 6 Starship V3s are being built and prepared for their maiden flight. Now, let's discuss the improvements we can expect on the V3. Size-wise, there likely won't be any major changes compared to the V2 series. The major changes are expected to occur internally. The main changes will be in the placement and design of the header tanks and internal fuel lines. This will help maximize space inside the nose cone. This will create more room for carrying cargo, which will become increasingly important as Starship prepares for its missions. This includes the ability to carry cargo or even people. With more thrust and a changed weight distribution, the V3 can carry heavier loads, which means more internal space and an improved nose design are needed. While the size remains the same, other external changes are starting to become apparent. For example, the lift points at the top of the nose cone appear larger. This is likely due to the current lack of heat shielding tiles, but it could also indicate changes have been made to accommodate the larger size and weight of the V3. We'll need a more robust lifting system for stacking and moving items. Another significant change is the weld pattern, particularly the horizontal welds. These weld patterns appear to be more prominent and common than in previous versions. This could be a structural enhancement to strengthen the center of the nose cone. This section will need to withstand increased heat and stress during flight and upon return to Earth. It appears they've changed the way the heat shield is attached. The number of mechanical pins has been increased, and they're now more prominent on the nose cone. This change will likely reduce the need for adhesive tiles, which have been notoriously difficult to install in hot weather. Now, with more tiles held in place by mechanical pins, Starship should be stronger and better able to protect against heat during re-entry. While these changes may seem small, they point to a larger trend of improvement over time. Larger improvements like new flap designs, changes to the base structure for carrying payloads, and improvements to the internal tanks will likely come once we see more fully assembled V3 vehicles. Progress is progressing rapidly in Megabay 2. Both S39 and S40 now have their mounting pins, meaning they're ready to be fitted with heat shields and moved to the platform for stacking. Work on S39 will begin soon, utilizing the currently available capacity. Following the S36 incident, only S37 and S38 remain in Megabay 2. The rear section of S38 arrived in late May and has now been added to the front section, completing its main structure. If SpaceX sticks to its regular schedule, they will begin stacking S39 in July. Based on past trends, the complete stacking process typically takes about 4 to 6 weeks, so we can likely expect the completed S39 to launch in late August or early September. Once stacked, the rocket will undergo a full series of tests, adjustments, and inspections. This typically takes another 1 to 2 months. This timeline suggests that Starship V3 could possibly fly before the end of 2025. The V3 booster, called B-18, appears to be making good progress in production. The rear section was spotted in early May, and in mid-June, they installed the ring extension. This means B-18 could complete all its production steps first and could be ready before S39. As the hardware improves, the ground system is also getting closer to being ready. If V3 is scheduled to launch later this year, Pad B will likely be the mission site. Pad B has already completed most of its construction and will soon be tested. Using the new booster and spacecraft as well as the new launch pad will be an exciting next step in Starship's development. Are you excited about the Starship V3 launch this year? If so, leave a comment saying, "Let's launch Starship V3" to show your support. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel to stay up to date on SpaceX's incredible journey. Here's a question for you. Did you notice the most important detail from the recent V3 nose cone reveal? One important thing to note is the production rate. We're now seeing 6 nose cones appear simultaneously, which clearly indicates that production is ramping up rapidly. In comparison, V2 production was much slower, with only 5 known prototypes, S33 through S37. Version 1, on the other hand, saw a similar surge in activity. After the second flight, Musk shared an image of 4 V1 starships parked along a highway.
At that time, parts S28 through S32 were in different stages of completion. S32 was completed on November 16, 2023, just 3 days before the second flight. SpaceX also had ships S25, S26, and even S20 still being assembled. In just a few days, they'd assembled 8 V1 vehicles. It's important to understand that reaching that number took over 2 years, starting with S20 in mid-2021. Back then, production rates were much slower than they are now. Now, seeing 6 V3 nose cones emerge simultaneously shows that Starship production is ramping up significantly. As mentioned earlier, Mega Bay 2 is now ready to go and can accommodate 2 prototypes at a time. Currently, it takes a little over a month to stack each ship. If this continues, SpaceX could have all 6 V3 prototypes completed by the end of the year. This demonstrates a much faster production rate than we saw with V1 or V2. This highlights how much Starship V3 can change things. The real challenge is manufacturing the rest of the vehicle. Components like the fuel tank and the rear section are much more complex than the nose cone. That's where Star Factory comes in. Known as the world's first mass production rocket factory, Star Factory is built for efficient manufacturing. Musk said the production line is arranged in a straight line, with different stations, each building specific parts of the vehicle. This setup is based on how Tesla's Gigafactory builds things. We can expect all parts of Starship, from the nose cone to the engine bay, to be manufactured domestically much more quickly, although the facility isn't yet operating at full capacity. Looking ahead, Star Factory could be fully operational by the end of this year. This is crucial because SpaceX aims to conduct at least 25 flights from Starbase by 2026. To meet that demand, we need to produce at scale. Another important factor, besides Star Factory, is the sheer size of the existing stacking capacity. Currently, Mega Bay 2 can likely accommodate 5 to 6 prototypes simultaneously. However, this facility may not be the best choice for rapid stacking in the near future. This draws attention to the new Gigabay, a major construction project underway at the site of the old High Bay. Demolition has been completed, and SpaceX is now laying the foundations. Construction is likely to begin this month or next, and is likely to be completed by early to mid-2026. Once operational, Gigabay will be able to manage 10 to 15 Starship and Super Heavy prototypes simultaneously, further increasing production rates. And that's not the end of its growth. SpaceX aims to build 1 Starship per day in the long term. To achieve this, more infrastructure is needed. After Gigabay, similar structures will likely need to be built. Even the current large bays will likely be replaced with newer ones to improve their functionality.
Florida needs to expand because it has 2 active launch pads, LC-39A and SLC-37. These pads are expected to handle 44 and 76 launches annually, respectively. The Florida site will need its own production facility. A new Gigabay is planned for the Roberts Road campus, and a 2nd Star Factory is expected to be built simultaneously to help with the production of more prototypes. Engine production also needs to be increased. Starship V3 will have Raptor 3 engines, which are much easier to manufacture than the older version. Raptor 2 can now produce 1 engine per day due to its simpler design. Raptor 3 will likely perform even better, perhaps producing multiple engines daily to meet demand. With these improvements, SpaceX appears poised to meet its flight goals this year, including the first flight of Starship V3. It's uncertain whether that flight will attempt to capture it in 2 stages, but next year is highly likely. After achieving those milestones, bigger goals will emerge. These include developing a refueling system, conducting a test landing on the moon without a propeller, and eventually sending a mission to Mars. To achieve this, SpaceX needs to maximize its 2 remaining V2 prototypes. The vehicle will need to demonstrate fundamental skills, such as executing a full flight path, dropping a payload, performing well in space, surviving re-entry, and successfully landing in two stages. Flight 10 will likely end with a splashdown in the ocean. This will set the stage for Flight 11, where Starship will attempt to capture something for the first time. With six V3 nose cones on display and major upgrades being made to the facility, everyone is curious about how SpaceX will begin this new phase. How they begin the V3 era could impact the future of the Starship program to 2026 and beyond. Johnston Island is well positioned for travelers between major continents like the Americas, Asia, and Australia. It is also a good base for missions to difficult regions like the Arctic and Antarctic. Establishing a rapid transportation hub in this crucial location would allow for rapid delivery of services worldwide. This capability would significantly enhance U.S. military operations and aid international humanitarian efforts. This system could help quickly execute missions to maintain global security, deliver aid during disasters, and move people to safety during emergencies. Whether responding to conflicts or natural disasters like hurricanes, floods, earthquakes, and volcanoes, or providing medical assistance, this system can make a huge difference. Beyond military use, groups like medical teams, charities, and aid agencies will benefit greatly from this system. That's all for today's episode. See you in the next one, and thank you for your support.